Hi everybody, my name is Antoinette and this is Board Game Inquisition, where we're kind of obsessed with giving you insights and information about the board games you might want to have in your own collections. So are you in the mood for a train game? One where the focus is all on the money, where you're headed next and rising through the stock market? Well, if so, then here's five things I think you need to know about Railroad Rivals. In Railroad Rivals, you create and invest in train lines. On your turn, you draft stock tiles to build up your portfolio. And then you draft city tiles, which you can connect with other tiles to create links between cities. When you do, you place goods onto the city, which you then deliver for victory points and to raise the value of your stock. The winner is the person with the highest combined stock value and victory points. Thing one, what's this game all about? Well, Railroad Rivals sets you up as a business mogul in the era of Great American Trains. So you're going to build networks, you're going to move goods, and you're going to try and increase your stock prices as much as possible. It's all very economic and money driven. Is this an original theme? No, there are lots of games in which you combine economics and trains. In fact, they have their own genre, but that doesn't make this any less fun to play. I think there's something nice about sitting down and already understanding how a game is going to work because the theme is just that familiar. And combining economics and route building is a fun endeavor. I think we all can sit down and enjoy that. Now, the theme is definitely light here. You're not going to feel like a business mogul. Well, maybe you might. But really, the focus here is on mechanics. And being that the theme is so light, well, so are the mechanics too. Now, similar games to this, well, I'm reminded of something like Whistle Stop, for example, or perhaps one of those 18XX train games. But what Railroad Rivals has going for it is how light it is, how easy it is to pick up, and how easy it is to play. So it's kind of situating itself in a very different market to the other train titles. Thing two, mechanics. So Railroad Rivals really is a game about tile drafting and tile placement, where you're connecting your cities so that you can place goods out there so that you can then move them around to enhance the value of your stocks. This is the most bare bones economic game I've ever played. It's very simple, it's very straightforward, and it's also, I suppose, doesn't have much long-term thinking. And of course, this has its advantages. So the game is easy to teach, it's easy to learn, and it allows you to take risks that you might normally have taken in other economic games because it's not particularly punishing for them either. However, this kind of paring down does come with a price. So the game feels like it's got very little progression because your trains aren't connected to make routes, they're just connecting specific tiles. And you really do find yourself just dealing with, you know, whatever tiles come up at a time without being able to plan ahead. Secondly, I'm going to point out that if you do fall behind in this game, it can be difficult to make a comeback because so much is tied to your victory points and what you're able to bid for position at the start of the turn. And if you start falling behind in terms of points, it makes it harder to get out of that hole. I must say though, I do really like the way that you draft tiles. So on your turn, when it's your go, you can decide if you want a tile that is a stock or a tile that is a city. So you don't get to take both of your tiles together and you've got to wait and see what might be left for you by the time your turn comes back. And I think that was a really intelligent insight. And I really like how that plays out and kind of the banter between the players as this goes on. However, there are a lot of stocks in this game, and the stocks are written on the side of all of the tiles, and of course you draft these stocks as the game progresses. My problem is that I think there are just literally too many stocks. Like there's loads upon loads of them. You could play half of your game and not have run into any of them yet. And when they're written on the side of your tiles and you've no way to connect them up, I just found it made the game a little unwieldy. And it also, I suppose, it kind of made your actions feel a little less special or a little less important because you had so little control over, you know, what was happening or what was coming up next. This game's appeal is clearly its easy and accessible approach to economics. Thing three, on the table. So Railroad Rivals has kind of an old-timey feel to it, and you'll see this as you build out the board as you play. It actually looks a lot like something like Carcassonne, where you're building routes and connecting places, and it spreads out all over the table. Now, it's easy to set up and take down because it is entirely made of tiles, and the rulebook is clear, concise, and actually pretty easy to read, which is nice. Now, it takes 40 minutes for two of us to play and about an hour 20 for four, but the turns are quick and timely. Replayability wise, well, there's lots here because it really is, you know, connecting different sides of tiles together. But my version also came with a hotel and a water tower piece, which adds some additional rules to give you even more ways to play. Think four, how does this game look and feel? Well, Railroad Rivals really does have an antiquated vibe to it, and it's one I particularly appreciated. You see it in font choices and in colours, and in some of the graphic design too. The component quality here is excellent. I have to say that these tiles are incredibly chunky and thick and weighty, and I really, really appreciated that. And everything in this game has a bit of class to it. You can tell a lot of care has been put into making all of the components. Artwork-wise, I'm kind of obsessed with the sleek and clean art that all of the city places got. The artwork that is given for each character, however, seems completely disjointed from this world we see in the pictures of the cities. It's very cartoony instead, and I don't feel like it fits with it a whole lot. However, I have to point out that each character is both male and female on either side, so you can play every character you might want. And that's something I personally really appreciated and wish more games did. I think it's a really nice touch. The final part I have to mention here, I suppose, is to do with graphic design, and that is the fact that each stock is written, well, on a variety of tiles so that you can connect them together. But it's very difficult to read all of them when there are four of them printed around the edge of your tile. And also, the stocks normally come with a logo and they have their own colour, but that's not the case when it's printed onto the tile. So it can be very difficult to follow which stock is which when you're looking at them all in your hand. And I think that's a shame, really, that if they were maybe colour-coded the same way as the stocks, they would have been much easier to connect and to read. I just think it added a level of impermeability that wasn't particularly necessary. But overall, this is a really good looking game. Think 5. Is this game actually any good? Well, it's definitely incredibly fun, and the first couple of times I played it, I really, really enjoyed it because it combines everything I love about stock games with tile laying games. Like, how could this be a bad thing? And you know how economic games take themselves kind of seriously? I just love that this game didn't. I love that it was just straight up that this is a simple, fun economic game, you know, off you go, anyone can play it. But because that is the nature of this game, I found myself wanting more from it the more I played it. So I have issues with the catch-up mechanism or lack thereof for anybody who's in last place. It's just very difficult to make your way back on top. I have issues with the huge variety of stocks because it meant you could control very little of what you were doing. And some people I think will appreciate that, and I think this game is aimed at those type of people who just want to have fun and enjoy themselves and not to think too, you know, difficultly or, you know, get too involved in what's going on. Just kind of, you know, getting one up on their friends, making your stocks worth some money. You know, it's got that whole atmosphere going to it. But for me, I wish there was more because it starts out so good. But I think if it did give me what I wanted, this would be a very, very different game than it is. So Railroad Rivals is really for people who want an economic game without all the hoo-ha and extras and to have a fantastic time. And I think it does a really, really great job at that. Do I think you should have Railroad Rivals in your collection? Well, if you're the kind of person that wants a fun and fast economic game, the one where you're gonna earn a ton of money and annoy your friends, then this is a game that's definitely worth checking out. You've been watching Board Game Inquisition. Why not like or subscribe to the channel so you can get updates about my future videos? Or if you have any comments or queries you'd like to make about Railroad Rivals, why not shout them off in the comment box below? And until next time, tune in again for some more short and informative board game reviews.